Antaro Chronus serves as a sergeant of the Ultramarines chapter during the 41st millennium. The single most gifted tank commander of his chapter, Chronus has near mastered piloting every variant of the armored vehicles available to the Adeptus Astartes. Excelling when deployed within Whirlwind or Vindicator battle tanks, no foe can match his capacity for devastation when deployed within a Predator tank. Entrusted with machines of war beyond value to the chapter, Chronus adopts the very form of his adamantium chariot alike to a part of his own body. The viewfinders and sensors of his vehicle supplanting his human senses, rather than waging war with fists, chainsaws, or bolters, Antaro's pedigree and knowledge of the limits of armored warfare are the envy of even the Astartes of the Iron Hands and their descendant chapters. Charging into battle within his favored Predator tank, known as the Rage of Antonius, its damage incurred during the Damnos incident from a Necron Gauss cannon proved insufficient in diminishing the vehicle's valiant machine spirit. The tech marines of the chapter, marveling at the Rage of Antonius's constitution, all efforts were made to restore its functionality to peak performance, knowing the firepower it was proven to unleash. His maneuvers during the clash with the Necrons near miraculous. None have even come close to achieving such prowess in armored combat. Anointed the title of Spear of Macragge for his service, this ancient moniker not used since the days of the Horus Heresy would prove a fitting title for the chapter's foremost tank commander. Leading the chapter's armored assaults at their vanguard, Antaro is given free rein to choose which vehicle he shall pilot during each engagement. The 50 battle brothers under his command striving to achieve even a fragment of their leader's skill. No captain of the chapter has the authority to command the Spear of Macragge, for their expertise in armored combat pales in comparison, with only Chapter Master Marnaeus Kalgar and the returned Primarch Rebute Gilliman worthy of his submission to their will. Fighting alongside the Cadian shock troopers of the Astra Militarum during the conflict of Ironblood during 822.M41, Chronus gained victory over the traitor Warpsmiths and Masters of Possession, fielding the Land Raider, Gladius II. Earning unquestioning loyalty from the Cadians for his immense skill as a commander, the advances of Hellhounds, Banewolves, Predator Tanks, and Basilisks laid waste to the pawns of the Ruinous Powers. The wreckage of their war machines viewable from orbit, the tally of the Spear of Macragge earned him the badge of the Ironblood Campaign in recognition for his service. Facing the invaders of Ultramar during 999.M41, Chronus denied the advance of the Demon Prince Makar and Warpsmith Honsu upon the Agriworld of Quintan. Supporting the 5th and 6th companies of the Ultramarines chapter, the machine armies of the Dark Mechanicum and their benefactors could not deny the might of the Ultramar Auxilia whilst bolstered by their stalwart guardians. Allowing for the fortification of the city of Idrisia, Chronus's continued victory saw to the creation of a bespoke battalion. Dubbed the Spears of Macragge in recognition of their commander's honorific, this elite band of Ultramarine tank commanders waged war during the Second Damnosian War against the Necron Empire. Crucial in the battle to come, the Spears of Macragge, though stalled, managed to destroy the Necron Tesseract Vault and heavily damaged several monoliths upon the surface. Battle-scarred yet victorious, the Ultramarines managed to destroy the Necron forces and the unleashed Transcendent Shard of a Catan. To this day, the Spear of Macragge continues to fight in the name of his chapter, emboldened by the return of his Primarch and the vaunted deeds of his noble kinsmen.